I came to UT Health Science Center in San Antonio, originally for a postdoc to learn neuroimaging, but I ended up getting promoted to a faculty position in the psychiatry department here. We're generally focused on substance abuse related issues. One of the things we're really interested in studying is impulsive behavior. Impulsivity seems to be a really key factor for a lot of different disorders, but especially substance use. So people who have problems with drugs tend to be a lot more impulsive than people who don't have those. So what we're doing now is we're bringing kids at risk and following them up through adolescence and monitoring both impulsivity and how substance use develops. By at risk, these are kids who have had a parent with a drug or alcohol problem. We know from a lot of the research these kids are much more likely to develop problems with drugs. We'll do an assessment on them that includes some laboratory measures and computer-based tasks that measure different forms of impulsive behavior. With magnetic resonance imaging, we can measure brain activity on a slower scale, like over a course of seconds. We can do it much faster here by putting electrodes on the kids' heads. There's so much we don't know, and there's so much new discoveries being made all the time. The work I do, I think, is really interesting, and I think it's important to help prevent drug use in the future. When I was in high school, I was never, I think, very terribly ambitious student, and I was thinking it was about a BC average. It was really important for my parents for us to at least try college. My parents had never gotten a chance to go. They were able to save up enough money so that they could pay half our tuition. Midway through undergrad, I got more and more aware that if I wanted to go on to any type of graduate school, I would need some type of research experience.
I really pushed Ashley. I said, look, this is what's involved, and you'd have to do all this work, and you'd have to be independent. And is this really something you want to do? Oh yeah, yeah. It sounds hard, I want to do it. Okay, that's the guy I want.
When I was younger, I always would have thought that being a scientist would have been a really cool thing, but I never would have thought that I had the capacity to do something like that. And I think Meg was really one of the first people to see that in me, that I did have those abilities.
When Ashley was here, we were working in a part of the brain that was vital, not just to decision making, but also to eating. And we discovered, well, if we take that part of the brain out, if we lesion it, destroy it, the animal's gonna have a hard time eating from then on, and we need to keep them around for a while. So Ashley said, gee, wouldn't it be nice if instead of destroying this part of the brain, we could put it to sleep for a few hours, study when it was asleep? And he and I did some literature review, and lo and behold, we invented this new technique so that we could put brain areas to sleep rather than destroying them. And so because of that, he really pushed our progress forward. We were able to look at more areas and more animals more quickly and come to the decision, well, this is the area we should be focused on.
By the time I got to graduate school, I had a really good idea what I was getting to as a graduate student and also what the job market would be like when I finished.
If you took what's called an R1 university, a major research university like Madison, right down the road, most undergraduates, if they even got into a research program, like a lab or a faculty research program, would be working with graduate students and postdocs. They'd never really see the faculty member. They'd be consigned to relatively menial tasks, washing glassware, cleaning cages. It's very rare for them to really even get meaningfully involved. Here they have to. They develop confidence and competency and self-efficacy that they wouldn't if they were just washing dishes or cleaning cages. So it really is different here.
Graduate school isn't for everyone. Going to a PhD program isn't for everyone, but if that's really what you want to do, I think the advantage of being in a smaller program is you have that much closer contact with your mentors than you would in a larger program.
For me, obviously, it keeps my research going, and it's fun. It's so much fun working with these kids and asking these new questions and learning new things that I probably wouldn't ask myself. We do need to move towards recognizing that there are faculty on campus that devote a considerable amount of time, energy, resources to this kind of mentoring. How do we recognize and support people who choose to mentor undergraduate researchers?